Hi there, this is Steph with eMagCreator. This tutorial will show new and existing users of eMagStudio how to publish your eMags and how to create new publishing profiles that include mobile support and the speed loader. When you select or reach the Publish option in eMagStudio, you will be presented with the options of using the Publishing Wizard or Publishing Profile. Before getting started, it's good to note that you use the Publishing Wizard to create publishing profiles, which can then be saved and used again the next time you publish eMags. The Publishing Wizard can guide you through the options that are available in publishing. It's a good place to start if this is your first time publishing. First, you will need to choose whether you would like to publish it for online or offline reading. The next window will prompt you with various options. You will first need to choose either publish online or publish to hard drive for manual uploading to the web. Please note that when publishing to your hard drive, you will not be able to correctly view or share your eMag until it has been manually uploaded to the web. Selecting publish online will prompt you with three key options as to where you would like your eMags to be published. First is our new eMagCloud.com, which is the free premium hosting included with your service subscription. If you have not used this option yet, you will be prompted to set up your profile via your portal before continuing. The next two options, for FTP or Amazon, are what you should use if you wish to host your eMags on your own servers. You will need your FTP and login details to use these. Once you have chosen where to publish, the next option you see is a checkbox for mobile support of your eMags. This will create the HTML5 output files so that your eMags can be read on mobile devices. The last checkbox in this window is to enable the speed loader for online editions, which will increase the loading speed of your eMags. This is included by default when using the eMagCloud, but will require some additional technical setup via your Publishing Profile Manager when self-hosting. If selecting either of the self-hosting options, the next window will prompt you to enter your FTP or Amazon login credentials. After this, you will then be asked if you want to save the publishing profile for later use. If you plan on using the same settings for later publications, this is recommended. You're now ready to publish. If instead you would like to use a saved publishing profile, such as the one you have just made, simply select the Publishing Profile box on the main publishing window. You will then be able to choose an on- or offline publishing profile that you have previously saved or use a default profile. A great profile to use if you're publishing to the eMagCloud is the profile of the same name. It has the speed loader already set up and mobile support enabled. Once the profile has been chosen, simply click Publish. Once your eMag is finished being published, the URL will be shown. You can click View eMag to see the finished product. Finally, I will explain the features that can be found in the Manage Publishing Profiles option under the File menu. Here, you can easily create or edit your publishing profiles. It's a great way to make small changes to an existing profile or to create several profiles at one time. If you are using an FTP or Amazon, you will need to enter settings for this method to work. Mobile support and the speed loader can also be enabled on this screen. There is a separate tutorial about the speed loader and how to set it up in your profile. In this tutorial, you've learned how to publish using the wizard and publishing profile, and how to add and edit publishing profiles to fit your needs. Make sure to check out our other eMagStudio tutorials. Bye for now!